It seems to me that the multiverse idea is a continuum of human thought. The first cave dweller to come out and look up and see some bright things in the sky that seemed to be going around him, he thought, wow, I'm right in the center of it all. And then slowly but slowly, we find the sun, and then we're at the edge of the galaxy, and then there's many galaxies. The next step would be a multitude of cosmoses, of universes. You add them all up, a billion of them, and the theory would say, the math would say, it's possible to have another Earth and another you.
Popular culture, novels, books, films have dealt with this idea of alternative realities, parallel universes. There's this idealized path that we all have, and sometimes life just goes the other way.
Yep.
And sometimes you just can't help it, but you're shaking off that path. There's no way you're going to get to that version of yourself, but perhaps a different, the one that lives the harder path, the more challenging path, if those two people were to confront one another, maybe that one has had the more profound and meaningful experience.
You know, that's so beautifully put. You were sentenced, or your character, in the film to 4 years in prison, which happens to be the length of time you would have gone to MIT.
University, yeah.
And you gotten your bachelor's degree.
Yeah.
You would have just graduated, no doubt being headed to grad school, probably to get a PhD, probably for a great career, but now you're an ex-con. That girl, that woman, has a really rugged time. Now, if you meet your other self, what has she gone through? Think about that.
Why do we all feel that possibility? Like, everyone has ruminated on the idea of a doppelganger. And does that point to the possibility that we all feel something primally and instinctively, because there's maybe truth to it? Maybe the reason we daydream about doppelgangers and like alternate realities is because we're intuitively arriving at something that is mathematically true. We just don't have the proof yet.